So I went to London and all I came back with was some theatre merch. And I'm thrilled! Welcome to Vlog 2.6! Hello, welcome to Vlog 2.6! COVID secure! More about Sleepless later. So yes, I've been to London and now I'm back. As is my scruffy beard and dark hair. This is for some filming that I've got coming up. Booked and blessed. Anyway, back to theatre. So I want to start off by giving a huge shout out to Adam Haig, the choreographer behind Soho Cinders, who has just started his new job as deputy head of dance at Italia Conti. He has spent 5 months recently working at Sainsbury's, and it's incredible that he's now back teaching in the newly reopened Italia Conti. Here is a brilliant video that he posted about his time working at Sainsbury's.
Going down aisle 12. Roasted peanuts. Would anyone like a try of my willy? God, you know how to push my... Oh, hour number 4. I'm getting a bit bored. What's the topic of conversation?
Oh, I'm starving. I just fancy some catacolta.
Get a speed on.
Cheeky bastards.
Just nearly had a crash.
I am what I am. I can't see a word. And all there.
Oh, sorry.
Let us know. In times of COVID-19, let's all keep our spirits high.
Beat it, beat it.
I know we've been. Oh, what am I like? After time.
Go, go, go.
Clean up on aisle 20. But I'm always true to you, darling, in my fashion. Oh, look at me, Babs.
I'm going home.
Elsewhere, Ed Watson popped up in The Guardian this week in a collection of photos celebrating his work with the Royal Ballet, which he is now retiring from. He will continue to work with the ballet as a coach. Now, over at Regent's Park Theatre, Jesus Christ Superstar is continuing to sell out and is open now until the 27th of September. And they have just released this trailer. Like me, you spent most of lockdown watching online performances on Instagram. You might not have missed Steph Parry and Ross Harmon. They literally got me through some of the early months with their evening concerts, and they even paired up for a few duets. They are now bringing their show called Lockdown Duets Live at the Crazy Cocks with the incredible pianist Ben Papworth. Scheduled for Sunday the 25th of October, they sold out within minutes, which is incredible. And they have now released an extra night on Tuesday the 27th. If you want to see them, have a look at this trailer for more information. She's also managed to sell out with a show Sundays at the Musicals at the Actors Church. Scheduled for the 4th of October, you have no longer got a chance to get a ticket. Sorry. Meanwhile, tickets are now on sale for the next Sunday at the Musicals on Sunday the 22nd of November at 5:30 and 8 o'clock. Meanwhile, Ben Papworth has teamed up with Stuart Saint and Keith Ramsey to produce a new show at the Crazy Cox on the 9th of October called Brass Liquor. I love Keith Ramsey. He is an incredible performer who you might have seen in the stunning production of Preludes at the Suffolk Playhouse.
Describe your day.
Describe my day. My day began with waking.
Now, the gorgeous Joshua St. Clair, who was last seen in City of Angels casually rubbing the legs of Vanessa Williams, has been cast in Frozen, the musical. In preparation for this, he will be keeping a video diary on YouTube called From Shabby to Pabby, A Fitness Journey, which will explore his progress as he begins to get into shape for the part. Now, this is incredible as Josh will guide us through his own insecurities with his body and talk about his goals to get fitter. Now, there's no denying that Josh is already in pretty good shape. I remember seeing him at Roles Will Never Play and texting his boyfriend afterwards to say, oh my God, Josh's arms are amazing. I was so jealous. But what I love about these video diaries is that Josh even opens up about his own insecurities about his body, including the scars that he has on his torso from an operation. Now, this is incredible to see somebody talk so candidly about body image, and it's really inspiring. I will definitely be tuning in to see how he gets on. Now, Nadeem Naman has put together a special, beautiful video from Broken Wings to raise money for Beirut. Filmed at the Suffolk Playhouse and edited at the Barn Theatre, this video is stunning and features performers like Heba Aishik and Rob Houchin. The video has already had 7,000 views and raised over £6,000, which is incredible, but it can keep going. I spoke to Nadeem last month about his intentions to make this video, and I cannot believe how beautifully it's turned out. It's stunning.
Whenever I close my eyes, I see the magic of the valleys, those mountains of glory whose greatness brushes the sky. Whenever I shut my ears to the clamor of the city, I hear the breaking of waves and the rustling of trees.
Now, meanwhile, if anybody's looking for a sports massage, Hamilton star John Scott Clark is back on the road with his company Massage on Tour. So if you are after a sports massage from somebody who will possibly sing you a couple of songs from Hamilton afterwards, make sure you get booking. Over on ITV's This Morning, the Jersey Boys were back in town with the brilliant Dale Hodge, Simon Bailey, James Winter and Carl James Wilson. Now if, like the thousands of us who were kept entertained by Philip Joel's brilliant series of online monologues, he has put together his own pilot of a brand new comedy series that he hopes to make called the Fosse Forest Ballet. It will be filmed on the 8th and the 9th of September and is directed by the incredible Racky Plews. And they are hoping to raise over £10,000 for charities through downloads. I'm just waiting for the call to see if I want a cameo in it. Please. 5 years ago, I produced a production of Parade at the London Theatre Workshop for Ray Rackham. And its stars, Ross Barnes and Lily Delahaye, have teamed up for a brilliant new version of one of the songs.
All the wasted time.
This was a stunning production, which I was really, really proud to be a part of. And it is so nice to see these guys come back together online. Maybe it's time for a revival. Now, showbiz couple Madeleine Alberto and John Addison are over in Portugal where they've spent some of the time during lockdown. They are teaming up for a brand new live online show. The musical review will be filmed live in Portugal on September the 18th and is being described as part play, part concert. These guys are incredibly funny and lovely. Madalena, who played Eva Perón in Evita and Grisabel in Cats, is sensational. So this show is bound to be full of classic show tunes. Nottingham Playhouse Unlocked have announced a new series of works starting from the 21st of October. The 3-week festival will be the first live event to happen at the Nottingham Playhouse since lockdown. Performers Sandra Marvin, Rosalie Craig and Jodie Prenger will be taking part in concerts with songs from their careers. Mark Gatiss and Jane Anuka will be reading ghost stories on Halloween, and there will be new work from playwright James Graham, whose West End play Quiz was recently adapted and screened on ITV. For full details of the festival and the rest of the lineup, visit nottinghamplayhouse.co.uk. Now, meanwhile, Rosalie Craig will be teaming up with her husband, Hadley Fraser, for a brand new production of Before After at the Suffolk Playhouse. Written by Stuart Matthew Price and Timothy Knapman, this production was originally commissioned as a Japanese production in 2014 and was workshopped at the Other Palace. It is now going to be brought back to the Suffolk Playhouse as a live streamed event for 3 performances over the 25th and 26th of September. This week, ITV screened a documentary featuring Sheridan Smith called Becoming Mum. In the documentary, she details her incredible story about her battle with anxiety and alcohol. It is an incredibly moving documentary, but also incredibly uplifting and brilliant to see Sheridan Smith taking control of her issues. And is incredibly inspiring to see how becoming a mum has completely transformed Sheridan's life. The documentary is still available on ITV Player and she was most recently seen performing a tribute to Dame Vera Lynn, where she looked stunning. Writer-director Ian McFarlane is bringing his new production, The Revellers Society, to the Oso Arts Centre in Barnes from the 5th to the 8th of November. Now, this is being described as an immersive promenade theatre show, which is brilliant. If you're not sure what that entails, it basically means you are led by the cast into different areas for the performance. And in this venue, you'll be guided through three different rooms. It sounds incredible and is set in the 1920s. So why not dress up for the occasion? Now, like I said at the beginning, I was down in London this weekend to get a COVID test and to start some filming at the Warner Brothers Film Studios. But I couldn't resist the chance to see as much live entertainment as I could. Starting at The Garden at Centrepoint, a brand new series of live music brought to you by Duality Music, live every day at Centrepoint. Now, this is being produced by James Baker. Now, although it's completely free to watch, all the artists are getting paid thanks to the generosity of Centrepoint. And they even provide free tea and coffee in case you get a bit chilly. Now, this is a brilliant initiative to try and encourage people to come into the city to see these artists. And it is great for them to be back at work, getting paid to do their thing. Now, of course, a few people had to criticise it by saying that it's devaluing the work that they do by giving it away for free. I don't see it like that. Now, during lockdown, there have been a lot of people performing online for free, as well as companies like Andrew Lloyd Webber giving their entire show away for free on YouTube. Now, the way I see it, I think it's really, really necessary to see live music return and to try and encourage people to go out to find live music. And at the moment where money might be tight, if it's free and affordable, then that is a much better alternative. My concerns are that if people become accustomed to watching music or theatre online, they're going to lose the appeal of seeing it live. Initiatives like this, which are designed to reintroduce an audience to live music, are so important and so necessary. And ultimately, it's giving paid work to all these performers. I managed to catch a few of the performances over the weekend, including Emma Salvo from Come From Away and the gorgeous Kayleigh McKnight. Recorded that, sadly, the entire series has been shut down by Camden Council following noise complaints from residents. This is a real shame, and I genuinely feel so much for everybody involved. On Thursday evening, the Union Theatre opened their doors for their first live performance since lockdown with a socially distanced audience. Roles Will Never Play Emerging Talent had 26 artists who performed in front of the socially distanced audience and online, as the concert was entirely streamed. It was such an incredible platform for this collection of emerging artists, which range from recent graduates and students who are still studying. And I managed to interview all 26 of them during the show as each of them came off stage. And the entire video is now available on YouTube. Here are a few of the clips.
I loved my time there. It was a shame that it had to end the way that it did, but I wouldn't regret being a part of this year for those.
We've had so much support from everyone, really.
I've been doing lessons within a school called Western MT, which is all everything like through the Zoom. So like everything on Facebook, live Facebook and all of that, so which was really great as well, just to keep active.
I was waiting to go for a contract in April with Viking Cruises.
Of course you were, yeah.
So I was going to be going as a lead vocalist for that. So hopefully we'll be going on board sometime in the new year.
Well, at first I was like, I'm going to get fit, going to come out of lockdown with a six pack. Didn't go quite to plan.
So we were doing our second year showcase at the time.
Yeah.
And then, you know, the whole corona storm happened.
Yeah.
And all this kind of like, we're going to get shut, we're not, you know. And I was ill at the time, so there you go.
Really thought 2020 was going to be my year. Yeah, I know everyone says that, but I was convinced it was going to be my year.
Yeah.
Oh, I'd just come out of Panto. My Panto finished in January. And then like February, March, I was like, okay, ready to audition, get back into things. And then it was like February was going well, and then March suddenly came in. It was like, oh.
So we were in final rehearsals for our final show of The Fix. And then just one day, it was an email actually one morning, and it was like, don't come to Mountview.
Like loads of auditions that were in the pipeline that I had, and then they were just cancelled like that, and I was just like, great.
But it's like, we've just been locked up on the ship for 6 months. I don't know if I could do another 6 months. But yeah, especially with my balcony looking over London, it's kind of like the front of the ship. I feel like I'm just on there.
I've had a really good lockdown.
Yeah.
So me and Bob's are together. It's very wholesome. There was a lot of food. There was a lot of walking.
Like it.
There was a lot of arts and crafts. So.
Our showcase was cancelled the week before.
Yeah.
And we all just went home, which was so weird. One day we were in rehearsing the opening number, and the next day we were going home.
I feel like it all started off so well, and then obviously COVID hit, and I was like, stuff got cancelled, and I was like, oh, this is gonna really suck. But I think it was really good. There's so many online things to like keep me busy, so I didn't get like down in the dumps with it, and just staying very like motivated.
It was really crazy. Obviously, everything happened so quickly.
Yeah.
But like, I think now I'm kind of in like the reflective stage where I'm like, what an amazing time, what an amazing experience I had. To be
got a lot of our stuff done. The only thing it affected was our grad show, but now we got to film stuff at home and do it that way, so it was all good.
I'm in a bit of a different circumstance because I'm not actually going back. I've got something coming up.
It was what it was. I think everyone's in the same position, so you can't really complain too much.
Bittersweet, because obviously we didn't get to do our shows. We were quite lucky. We were like one of the last people to do our showcases, so we can't complain about that.
Yeah, I feel so lucky to have my graduation, like stuff that 2020 grads haven't ever had.
Yeah.
So, but it's still opportunities like this.
Yeah.
They don't come around that often anyway, so it's amazing to be part.
Strange.
Yeah.
But I think it's the same for everyone. I mean, we wrote a musical.
Yeah.
We started a concept of the show, and we basically, like, our own little baby show came into fruition. And that was great.
Like getting back on a stage with an audience, even with people watching online as well, it's just that moment of hopefully this is the start of things returning to normal.
Yeah.
On Friday, I returned to Above the Stag, who have now opened their bar from 3 p.m. to 11 p.m. It was lovely to be back in the venue, which hasn't opened since lockdown, but will be returning later this year with their Christmas panto. Meanwhile, they opened the doors to their new socially distanced cabaret lounge, which kicked off with Tim McArthur's show, Mountains. After this, I raced over to Freedom Bar Soho, where Carmen Lanny is now performing on Friday evenings, as well as hosting Kinky Cabaret on a Monday. Safety measures have been taken, which include you getting your temperature taken as you enter, and you have to sign the track and trace information. As well as this, there is now table service and you have to remain in your seat. I'll be honest, it felt weird to be back in the venue, which I used to spend a lot of time in, and not be able to swing round a pole or dance because there's no music. But it was nice just to go there, see some familiar faces, have a drink and enjoy the entertainment, courtesy of the brilliant Carmen Lanny. On Saturday morning, despite a little bit of a hangover, I took my first gym class in 6 months at Digme in Ealing. Digme now have 7 locations around London that have begun to open up and are still continuing to provide their online classes. I took part in Combat HIIT with Justin Thomas, and I honestly thought it was going to kill me. But it wasn't actually that bad. But Justin was so lovely. And although my legs were killing for 2 days afterwards, it was brilliant just to get back in a gym environment with other people. Now, Digme have taken precautions to keep everybody safe, including social distancing, one-way systems, and a temperature check on arrival. And it was lovely to see my pal, Brett Sinclair, who also works there. Now, over at Archer Street, I was back to watch their entertainment, courtesy of Kevin Fagan and his Disney Happy Hour. I used to spend a lot of time in Archer Street, and it's brilliant to see live music return to their venue. And again, they are taking every precaution to keep the audience and the customers safe by providing table service and a one-way system to go to the toilet, which include a traffic light system to get up and down the narrow staircase. It was great to see Kevin and the team performing again. And I have to give a huge shout out to Charlotte Wood, who was incredible. Everybody who performs at Archer Street is sensational, and it's so, so nice to see them all back at work. After this, I went over to the Phoenix Arts Club for the Saturday Super Show, hosted by the brilliant Michael Twait.
She's thinking, Rick has good girl. I may just sit and enjoy the show.
She's the worst. She doesn't look at you like a normal cat, would avoid eye contact. But he just sits in his mailbox staring straight at me while squeezing one out.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna get in trouble for that. There's a little bit of trepidation about this. She's from the Do It Yourself. Go wild, make a lot of noise, and welcome to the Phoenix Arts. Sammy Mathis Jr. Normally say the word Tory on stage, that's really rude.
On Monday, I was back at Kinky Cabaret. I used to spend a lot of time at Kinky Cabaret on a Monday evening, and I've really, really missed it. It was so nice to see performers Claire Cordell, Claudia Karaoke, Carl Mann, Rosalind James, with Dwayne Lamont returning, and the brilliant Carmelani hosting. Champion artists and performers, and regularly post videos like those across my social media, Instagram, Twitter and Facebook, and I regularly post in the forum All Things West End. Now, I was a little taken back when I posted that video of Carl in the forum, which divided opinion. It raised a lot of questions and concerns from people asking whether social distancing was even in place in Freedom. Now, I agree, on the surface, when you watch those videos, it doesn't look like it was. But I assure you, I was there and I took the video. All the comments that were made about the videos were absolutely valid, and the people are entitled to express them. But what I struggled with was the aggression levied behind some of the comments and targeted at me for uploading the video. I apologised to anybody who I offended with the videos, but tried to make it clear that I was posting those videos to champion the artists and to celebrate the venues for reopening within the guidelines that I did see them adhere to. Now, people are obviously entitled to their opinion, and I welcome this. I think it's important and healthy to have conversations and to flag things, but some of the comments were very targeted and quite aggressive. And ultimately, this is a community of theatre lovers. We're supposed to be supportive of each other, and it hurt when a lot of the messages were directed at me and the venues and the performers. As a result of this, I contacted Carl Milani from Freedom Bar and Michael Twaits from the Phoenix Arts Club and invited them to take part in my stagey chat conversation. And together, along with producer Stuart Saint, we had a full and open discussion about some of the questions raised. Please do watch the episode.
At Freedom, here's you know, the deal. We are operating at probably around 35% capacity of where we have been, or what we were allowed sort of pre-pandemic. The rules and regulations are in place are very much the same, I should imagine, as every other hospitality venue that has reopened in this new sort of post-apocalyptic world. You know, you have to have booked a table. And in the booking process, we obviously get all of your details for the track and trace system. And you also have to, at the time of booking, if you are booking for groups of, say, 4, 6, 8, you have to declare that these are people that you are either cohabiting with or that are happily, to coin this new fabulous word, bubbling with. And we obviously can't police that. That is up to the great British public's, you know, honesty. And I should hope common sense to say that if these are the people that you are happy to sit in close proximity to for the 2 or 3 hours of the show, then we have to trust that you are telling the truth and that's fact. And all of that is clearly stated at the time of booking. If you haven't booked, and if you know, although booking is recommended, if you haven't booked and you arrive at the venue, then you are temperature checked. You are given a QR code to scan that links directly to our track and trace system, where you and, you know, one member of each party, be that 2, 3, 4, have to give us your details for the track and trace system. We are doing our absolute best to keep our customers safe. We have taken every precaution that we can. In the 2 months that Freedom has been operating, every single customer or party has been track and traced, and we have had no reported transmissions at all, zero. So that obviously goes to show that we are doing what we can inside the venue, and that we're trying to make sure that and that it's working. Just support the small businesses, especially small entertainment venues, small cabaret venues that are trying their best to take steps out of this. Yeah. Because if we don't, they may not be around.
Rich Watkins is bringing back his brilliant show, Happily Ever Puffter, to the Two Brewers on the 25th and 26th of September. I loved this show. I think it's really, really cleverly done. And it's exciting that Richard is bringing it back. I interviewed him last July all about the show, which you can still find on my YouTube channel.
Just tell us about that little show you...
About Happily Ever Pufter?
Yeah.
So it's called Happily Ever Pufter. It is a gay Disney parody. I wrote it after... Well, I grew up watching Disney films. I love Disney. Big Disney fan. So it's very much a celebration of all things Disney. But when I was growing up, well, once I realised kind of who I was and my identity in my teenage years, I realised that my story, my gay story, wasn't depicted in Disney. And I think that's true for a lot of people who maybe feel different in whatever way, that their identity and their story, their narrative, isn't shown in the stories that we're told as children often. It's changing these days, which is amazing. But I decided to write a gay Disney love story. So it's about a gay Disney prince, the world's first and only gay Disney prince, and his quest for true love.
On Tuesday, I was at the world premiere of Sleepless, the brand new production that has been brought to the Troubadour Theatre and is based on the 1993 film starring Meg Ryan and Tom Hanks. Now, this is the first fully staged musical to open since lockdown. In the reduced capacity from 1,300 to 400 people per show. It was due to open on the 24th of March, but was pushed back until the 25th of August and is now running until the 27th of September. Directed by Morgan Young, who directed Elf the musical and Big, it stars Kimberly Walsh, who starred in all three, and the incredible Jay McGuinness, who also starred in Big. Written by Michael Burdett, with British writers Robert Scott and Brendan Cull. Michael Burdett is confident that the show will get a new permanent home in the spring. Meanwhile, it'll be very interesting to see what the Troubadour do next, because their venue is very, very well equipped. Meanwhile, it is interesting to see what the Troubadour do next, because their venue is very, very well equipped for social distancing.
So the guests are arriving, getting their temperature checked before we all go in. It's a lovely evening here at the Troubadour. If you've not been, this is a new theatre in Wembley, which is brilliant. I've been before when I came before to see Sleepless last year when it previewed with Michael Xavier. It now has a slightly new cast, but should be incredible. So a quick bag check and a ticket scan, and we're in the theatre. So they've got a bar over here. And have a little look around.
You're behind me.
And there we go, look at this. I got a complimentary visor. That'll keep me protected. And a program which has an interview in it with Perry. Oh, please. He's right behind me. Give us a wave, Perry. There he is, social distance wave. And there's the rest of the audience, all about enjoy the show.
So we're just in the interval. It's probably the weirdest press that I've ever been to, not being able to really speak to anybody or see anybody. But it's a great show, and it's exciting just to be in a theatre space again. They're all doing an incredible, incredible job. There we go, take the mask off, show finished. Incredible work by everybody. It's nice to see, obviously I saw it last year when they were still previewing it and developing it. So it's nice to see it completely, fully finished. I hope it does really well. It's really nice to see British theatre. I know it's got an American involvement, but the two new British writers that have worked on it, I think it's really, really incredible. Lambert Jackson Productions are bringing a new production called First Date to the Crazy Cox from the 22nd to the 24th of October, starring Samantha Barks and Simon Lipkin. First Dates will also star Nicholas McLean, Danielle Steers and Oscar Conlan Murray. Now, this has been written by Austin Winsberg, who wrote the incredible TV series Zoe's Extraordinary Playlist, which, if you haven't seen, is incredible. It is available on All Four and stars Skylar Austin from Pitch Perfect. Now, I saw a workshop version of First Date at MT Fest UK, where it starred Liam Doyle, who performed one of the songs from the show at his concert, New Year, New Favourites.
I never knew what love was like until I saw your face. And suddenly I felt a love that time cannot erase. Your eyes so sweet and piercing, your manner kind yet strong. The kind of girl I can love forever. We'd spend the rest of our lives together. And in my life, I don't think I've ever been so fucking wrong. You're a bitch with no heart, you're a liar, you are Satan, and I hate the way you snore at night. All your quicks push me off, and I don't think I'm mistaken. Your compulsive need to always be right. You're bossy and judgmental, kind of tactless, boring too.
The Barn Theatre is to finally open for live indoor performances following the success of their Barn Fest, starting with the show Private Peaceful from the 10th to the 27th of September. Safety measures will include a new seating arrangement, Perspex sheets, and temperature checks.
We have just had our first performance back since COVID-19 hit.
That's fantastic, it's brilliant, yes.
Really, really wonderful and weird to be back in the theatre. Now, the show's very moving and, yeah, very, very enjoyable.
We have all worked so incredibly hard to try and survive, but also to bring theatre back.
Every minute is fascinating. You're gripped every minute of it.
I saw the show at Barnfest and then seeing it in the indoor theatre, it really brought it to life.
We had a live audience in the theatre applauding the show. Theatre is back.
It was moving, it was funny, and he played lots of different characters and played lots of music. So yeah, it was great. Come and see it, everybody.
When you're on the deep blue sea, will you sometimes think of me? I'll be waiting anxiously, soldier boy. So we're many miles apart, soldier boy. See my picture near your heart, soldier boy. When you've won your victory, God will...
The UK's first ever Big Top pantomime is to take place at the Luton Hugh Estate. Aladdin, a Genius will star Jamie Hensley from December the 15th to the 3rd of January.
Hello everyone, come along and join us at the Luton Hugh Estate this Christmas and I'll make sure all your wishes do come true. See you soon.
To the Theatre of Agrabah and enjoy this Big Top COVID-friendly panto, Aladdin. Tickets on sale now.
Pippin have announced a second extension for two more weeks, taking them up till the 11th of October. And for anybody who's missing Everybody's Talking About Jamie, Scott Nicol have done a cover of Out of the Darkness.
Well, you've come pretty far, but you know where you are, you're home. And the friends that you choose want to walk in your shoes, you're home. Anytime you feel your skies are falling, look above, see our bright silver line. Listen up at your own freedom calling. Calling you to a day when you're shining.
The brilliant drag superstars Portia de Flossi, Carla Bear, and Vermicelli have teamed up for That Drag Show. Good name. Their opening show will be at Proud Cabaret on the 8th of October with tickets at £20. And returning to the Suffolk Playhouse for their production of the last 5 years, Molly Lynch and Ollie Higginson are both coming back. And here is a trailer that they were planning to release earlier in the year.
Jamie arrived at the end of the line. Jamie is probably feeling just fine. And I'm still hurting.
I dreamed of writing like the high and mighty. Now I'm the subject of a bidding war. I met my personal Aphrodite. I'm doing things I never dreamed of before. My heart's been stolen, my ego's swollen. I just keep rolling along.
Goodbye until tomorrow. Goodbye until I crawl to your door. And I will be waiting. I will be waiting.
You never noticed how the wind had changed.
Goodbye.
They've also announced that they will be extending their run until the 14th of November and have announced that Lydia White and Josh Barnett will take on the parts as understudies. Josh Barnett has only just graduated this year from Arts Ed. Amazing work. Paul Whitehouse and the cast of Only Fools and Horses took part in a silent protest outside the Haymarket Theatre on Thursday the 3rd of September. Up to 30 cast members took part in a silent protest. The 15-minute silent stand was in solidarity of everybody in the UK theatre industry who has lost their jobs and not received any help from the government. It was also to highlight the lack of government guidance in reopening theatres and to implore the government to set a date when theatres can reopen without social distancing. And Juliet have announced that they will remain closed until March 2021, a full year since they originally closed earlier this year. This is devastating news for everybody involved in the production who is longing to be back on that stage. But on the same day, Anne Juliet posted this brilliant throwback to their flash mob that Cass performed last year on the Manchester Metro Link.
You are my fire, the one desire.
Yay!
cast of Be More Chilled will be returning for a special concert on the 26th of September, which it promises to include some reimagined versions of some of the classic songs from the show. Ashley Luke Lloyd's new immersive show, Alice in Wonderland Down the Rabbit Hole, is returning to the Aeronaut on Sunday the 27th of September. Songs for a New World, starring Rachel Tucker, Rachel John, Cedric Neal, and now with David Hunter, is coming to the London Palladium for two performances on the 11th of October. It will also include recent graduate Shem Omari James. And tickets start at £32. Actor and writer Drew Dillon has started a Kickstarter campaign to raise money for his audio play 34. Now, this is a brand new musical with 22 original songs with a LGBTQ plus theme. And if you want to help, please do watch this video for more information.
Hi guys, I'm Drew Dillon and I'm the writer and composer of 34.
And then there was this thing, this moment, this event I'll never forget. When the DUP tried to bring in this thing called the Conscience Clause, and its effect would be that, say, you're a bus driver, and as you neared me, you thought I was gay, well, you'd be well within your right to refuse me and drive away. Or you're a doctor operating on me, an emergency just brought in. Well, you could refuse to treat me because you didn't like who I loved. In your eyes, it's a sin.
34 is a brand new LGBTQ one-man pop musical set in Northern Ireland. It charts the story of a relationship as the fight for marriage equality intensifies. It has a score of 22 original pop songs. £10 will get you the digital EP, £20 will get you the digital album. There's a whole host of other rewards. I can't wait to see what we create.
They have until the 1st of October to raise £10,000. So if you can spare any money you have to help this brand new British writer, please, please get involved. Now, I've already heard some of the original music that's gone into this work, and it is brilliant. And here is a little cover that Fra Fee did of one of the songs.
They're the words I wish they'd say. I sing down by myself here today. I could pick up the phone, though I'm fully grown, cause I need you to see if me alone. When your words fall wise and direction lies, you're my master of battles won. Can you help me? What's the key?
West End performer Paul Wilkins has launched a brand new company called Opportune Theatre, set up to offer live theatrical events in a COVID-secure tent. Over at the Hope Mill Theatre, their production of Rent that was supposed to go ahead this summer has finally been rescheduled for the 30th of October to the 6th of December, and will be directed by the brilliant Luke J. Shepherd, who directed Spring Awakening there and then went on to direct Anne Juliet. And in amazing news, The Rule of Six. Six the Musical is coming back to the West End from the 14th of November for 11 weeks in its new home at the Lyric Theatre. This is incredible. NIMAX Theatre are taking the initiative to redesign their theatres so that all six of them can be opened by the end of the year. Kicking off with Six, which is transferring from the Arts Theatre to the Lyric, where Thriller the Musical sadly closed earlier this year. Now, they will be redesigning the auditorium to allow for social distance seating, and will be putting on 9 performances a week, with an extra matinee on Thursday being added to Saturdays and Sundays, with performances right through from Tuesday to Sunday. I cannot wait. I was dying to see this production earlier in the year when Sophie Isaacs and Danielle Steers joined the company, and I never got a chance, but now I do. I've already booked my tickets and cannot wait to see the West End lit up again. And not only that, the touring queens will be heading up to the Lowry in Salford for 6 weeks from the 27th of November. That is incredible. Well, that's all for now. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.